Good evening. The Lindt Cafe siege was the day terror struck the heart of Sydney. And in the 8 years since, much has been said about the attack. But one side of the story has never been told until now.
That's right. Nice to meet you, Damien Ryan.
His identity has been kept secret, but his heroics and that of his police mates are now legendary.
8 years ago, you went in. Tell me about it.
We were completely convinced that we were going to die to save a group of hostages we've never met before.
It was 8 years ago today when Man Monis, armed with a shotgun and what appeared to be a backpack bomb, walked into the Lindt Cafe and took 18 hostages. Today, the untold story of what happened next in a book by the officer who took down the terrorist.
It's a day that I will never forget and I think about it every day.
From edging closer to the cafe,
we pushed forward to the first window and we observed the hostages, seeing the distraught state they were in, all because of one man's actions. I felt an emotional attachment to them.
Knowing that to help them meant dealing with the threat of a bomb.
I was texting my wife, getting her to send more pictures of my little girl, who I believed wholeheartedly I'd never see again.
The execution of cafe manager Tory Johnson forced their hand and they went in.
You eyeballed him clearly?
Yeah, we locked eyes and I engaged and shot the terrorist. There's a lot that occurred after that as well that I don't stop thinking about.
Barrister Katrina Dawson was fatally wounded by shrapnel from a police gun. Louisa Hope, another hostage, was present today at the launch of Officer A's tell-all book, Tiger, Tiger, Tiger.
At the end, while hostages were running out, the TOU dudes were running in. If we contemplate the depth of bravery that requires, personally, it's beyond me.
Tony Abbott was the Prime Minister at the time.
There is evil in the world and we need people to protect us, and that's exactly what they do.
But it's taken its toll. Officer A has since left the force, writing the book, Therapy for Post-Traumatic Stress Disorder.
Do we need to learn from this?
I believe the police force need to do a lot more work in this area.
The New South Wales Police has always been opposed to the book and banned officers from his old unit from attending today's launch.
Even as late as last week, there were demands to remove certain things from the book.
Sometimes the truth hurts. That's how we live and learn. Damien Ryan, 9 News.